we're eager to tell stories about Jesus, Lord. We will share something about our personal lives that will magnify what Jesus has done for us. So this year's thought for the Vespers in the next few 10 months or so will be the story of Jesus Christ. Amen? Do you like to hear stories of Jesus Christ? But before I do that, I know you have been blessed. Those of you who have been attending for the past 1 month and two Sabbaths, that our speakers were discussing about the stories of Jesus. Amen? I'm not going to be tired of listening to the stories of Jesus. Tonight, I'd like to give you a little information or overview of the situation of Jesus, or the setting where Jesus was giving his parables and doing his miracles. Christianity, the story of Jesus, our Christ. You know, I subtitled this, The Fullness of Time. The Bible says in the Galatians chapter 4, verse 4, it says there, and I quote from this book, but when the time had fully come, God sent forth his son, born of woman, born under the law. I would like to underscore, fellow believers, the word there, when the time, and then had fully come. Meaning to say, friends, tonight, I would like you to know that our God, the Jesus whom we worship, operates and is perfect in his timing. During that time when Jesus first came to this world, the time had fully come. God sent his son, born of a woman, born under the law. This is the map of the ancient time where Jesus was born and was raised and did his ministry. Going to the west, if you know your directions, north, east, west, south, you know, this is the Middle East. You can see there Israel, the modern day Israel as it is, and you can see there in the map, the Mediterranean Sea. Just below the western side is what we call Egypt, the boundary to Israel. And you know what's happening right now in that country, Egypt. And on the eastern side is the country called Jordan. So this is where Jesus was born, and this is where Jesus had done his ministry. And in fact, friends, I would like to give you a little background of this land. Jerusalem by itself means the city of peace. But unfortunately, or sad to say, that city has been a city of strife even until now. Long before Jesus came to this world for the first time, at the fullness of time, Jerusalem or Israel, the surrounding nations, had been a land of strife, a land of suffering, a land of invasion, a land of bondage and exile. So this is the setting where Jesus Christ was born to be our Savior and to be our Redeemer. Friends, these are the passing, or this is the motion of the Jewish life. There are four major groups of Jewish religious parties during that time. And I would just like to tell you briefly why Jesus was so concerned of the religious practices of some of those parties during his time. These are the vicissitudes of the religious parties during the time of Jesus. Are you familiar with the Pharisees? How many of you here are familiar with the Pharisees? You've heard about it. Some of you had thought that the Pharisees were hated by Jesus, or these were a group of people that were despised. But I would like to tell you that this group of religious people are the popular party during that time. They were the party of the masses. And their only desire, they sought to, what do you call this, to uphold the law. They sought to uphold the law, and they would like the law to be relevant in whatever they do. That's why the Pharisees are what we term legalistic. They are very legalistic because they sought to be faithful to the law, especially the Torah, the five books of Moses, Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and Deuteronomy. And so this was the setting of what we call the Pharisees. They believe, friends, they believe, the Pharisees believe in the resurrection, in this eschatological resurrection. They also believe in the teaching of angels. But another group of religious party during the time of Jesus, what we call the Sadducees. You know them. And I would like just to briefly tell you why the Sadducees are also mentioned in the Gospels. The Sadducees were focusing more on the temple. Whatever they do, they focus on the rituals in the temple. And they are contrary to what the Pharisees believe. So this group of people does not agree with each other. All right? The Pharisees, they believe in angels. They believe in the resurrection. The Sadducees, they don't believe in the resurrection or the angels. They are just focusing on the rituals in the temple. They are temple-centered. That's why when you can recall your history, that's why when the temple of Jerusalem was destroyed by General Titus, the Sadducees became a weak party because the temple was destroyed. The next one are what we call the Zealot. The Zealot, if you know the Zealot, they are the ones who are, from their name, the party which are very enthusiastic in their defense of the Jewish faith. They would bring a dagger, remember? They would bring a dagger or sword just to protect their faith. If you are contrary to their faith, if you attack their faith, they will kill you. That's why Peter was one of the Zealots, because you know he took a dagger, and during the time of Jesus, when Jesus was being surrounded by a mob and was arrested, Peter took his dagger and cut the ear of Malchus. Do you remember the story? So this is one of the parties as well that was prevalent during the time of Jesus. And then the last major party that was prevalent during the time of Jesus, what we call the Essenes. The Essenes, friends, are those people popularly known to keep the scrolls, and they hid it in the Qumran caves. What are the Essenes? They are the ascetics. They don't get married. They are celibacies. They practice celibacy. They are what they call, they withdraw from the community or from the crowd. They would go and isolate themselves, or they would hide in a community where they are consider themselves as pure, and they would just write the scriptures by hand, and they would keep it. That's why we acknowledge the Essenes, to keep the record, to verify that the scriptures was indeed unadulterated, or they are true. Remember the Qumran scrolls, right? They were the ones who kept it, and they were the ones who copied it. These are the parties during the time of Jesus. So you can just imagine, friends, that Jesus, who was an upcoming rabbi or a teacher, he was mingling among this group of people. In our times, maybe we could say, in our present Christian experience right now, we could say, oh, that person is conservative, or that person is liberal, or that person is moderate, that person is like this, ultra-conservative, or that. We label, but these are the vicissitudes of the religious setting during the time of Jesus.